persons in Karachi who have invested their wealth in Panama. And overall, if you take into consideration the international report, there are 300 Pakistani entrepreneurs in this list, ex-journals and bureaucrats who has lost their money in Panama. So the total number of the Pakistanis is 300, and from Karachi, the biggest investment actually has gone, from Karachi, that is 2,204. So I know, because I've been living in Karachi for the last so many years, and since I've been working in this, and I meet a lot of people, because most people were not hidden faces. They were all known to me, and they were very kind to me, some of them. They said, "Yeah, we would like to talk to you. And if you don't try to mention and reveal our name, we will give you all that facts. How we are going to transport that money, and how that money which is actually the money of the people of Pakistan, and if all the Pakistani people actually should be benefited, but they had their own very substantial argument they gave to me, and which I wrote. But one of the things I would like to say, that this is not the only Panama where $100 billion has been, estimated to be lodged there. You know, when this present government came into power, Mr. Isaac Dar, while speaking for the first time in the National Assembly, he disclosed that there are $200 billion in Swiss bank. And he pledged before the legislator that he's going to bring back this money back to Pakistan, because Pakistan needs this money. And he also said that in case that money is brought back, we will be not in a position actually to go to the IMF for the loan and to sustain our giant economy. Is what he said in the National Assembly. But do you know that, well, his speech evaporated in the morning mist? Nobody then knew what's happening. There is no follow-up. Now when the Panama leaks actually came into discussion, it was revealed. And again, Mr. Sabda, just to hide the fact, he said that we are going to discuss about the Swiss bank account that should come back here. We will also discuss the Dubai bank accounts. Then he didn't mention the Bahrain offshore accounts. Because in Bahrain, I know in Bahrain how much money is lodged there. So he didn't mention that. So what I would like to say, what I have discussed this matter with Pakistani who has kept their money there. They say there are six reasons, and these six reasons I will reveal. Two of them have been revealed by Mr. Raza in his paper. There are six reasons, and these six reasons have been identified in the international journals, and especially in the Wall Street Journal. He says that the money which has gone there in Panama or elsewhere in a tax saving haven, first is the kickback money, then there is a money laundering, third there is an over-investing, fourth there are under-investing, then there is a money for terrorism, then there is a money for drugs, and then another thing which is very, very, very important is the money which has gone there to support terrorism and the anti-people governments. So these are the seven parts have been identified, by the international media. When I asked the Pakistanis who have put their money, I asked them, then what is your opinion? He said, yes, we have sent our money, it was not illegal money, and we have earned this money, and this is our, say we are wise people, we are intelligent people, we are not like you working for a, legal amount and just coming to us and taking our interview and then reporting it back. I said, whether I'm legal, whether you are strong, but the fact is that I'm a nationalist, and this is the reason why I'm asking you this question. He said the first reason is that whenever we pay tax to the tax collecting authorities, for example, I'm paying 1 crore rupees to tax authorities, they will come the next time and they say, look, you gave 1 crore rupees last year, now we will take from you 2 crore rupees because you have earned a lot of money and you're going to conceal it. So another pressure is built on them. He said, I'm a taxpayer, and honestly I have to say with you, you can look at my books, you can see my profit, you can see my losses, but they will not believe it. So the tax collection authorities in Pakistan, they are the one responsible actually for the transfer of the money from Pakistan elsewhere in a tax saving heaven. Second thing, they said that, do you know how long you have been in Karachi? I was born here, but you talk of Karachi. I said, it's my city. He said that from 2008 to 2013, election, and now 2016, do you honestly believe before the start of the targeted operation, Karachi was a safe place? Was it? was not there a flight of capital? The flight of capital was in Bangladesh, flight of capital in Dubai, flight of capital in Malaysia, flight of capital in Bahrain, flight of capital in Panama. He said it was the insecurity, social and political insecurity in the city of Karachi. Therefore, most of the people who earned money from Karachi, they said, this is not a place where we can invest our money, and we are going to put money outside. This is the second reason, you know, they have propounded, they discussed with me in detail, and very honestly this is it. And third is the government. He said that the government comes to know that particular organizations are earning huge money, then tax collection authorities apart, then there are doubts that will come. They said that, you know, since our political party is not working very well, so we need a lot of money because they are workers, we need to give food to our workers, so kindly, you know, donate some money. He said, I can give you the example, 50 big capitalists in Karachi only, they had to give enormous amount of money to the political parties. I'm not going to give the word because Dr. Haldar rightly said that they have not come here to give the name of the political party, but everybody who is sitting here, more enlightened than myself, they know who are who. So, because of this reason, they said they are going to transfer down money. They bought the property after India, said Pakistan is the second largest investor in Dubai. And then the first investor, the largest investor of Pakistani are in Malaysia. So, well, you can imagine that the political pressures, political instability, they were the factors that to be combined together, and this was the reason that they had to send their money abroad. So, this is the second. And third, he said, look, my nephew was kidnapped. And my nephew was kidnapped, and he said, this is my investigation because I was given this topic by Dr. Sarkar, that you have to investigate and you have to really go to the person concerned towards why they are transferring their money, to the Panama, to different parts of the world where the tax haven is there. You know, he told me my nephew was kidnapped. He said, then what happened? He said, Mr. Masood, that came to the paper. And after about a week, we were in a very hot water, even in turmoil, we were weeping. One of the finest men is sitting here from the CFLC, he can hear me out my statement because I was unable to discuss the name of the man, but he knows it. So what happened? He said, for 1 week we were in turmoil, we were weeping, we were crying, there was nobody actually to support us. The government didn't exist anywhere. How insecure we are here in the city of Karachi. And political party said, okay, we have the man, actually will go to the person concerned and we'll drag your nephew back. How much money? He said, you have to give at least 10 crores of rupees. He said, my God, 10 crores? You know, my this residence doesn't, you know, cost 10 crores. How much money have you? You know, after negotiation, you know, he had to pay 2 crore rupees and the nephew was brought back. And immediately he sent his nephew to Malaysia for further studies. And the trauma, parents and he himself undergone. You know, I know not that this who have been beating these people who have been kidnapped. So this is that. This is the third fact, you know, why the money is going from outside of Karachi. Fourth, there is a no respect for law. In Karachi, in Pakistan, there is a no respect for law. Because the law, the legislator, when they come being elected by the poor people, by the innocent people, by the half naked and half hungry people when they elect them, they come and they legislate. And all the legislators, I tell you honestly, they have got the best legislation in Pakistan. They got the safety of the woman, like money laundering, like anything is there. But they are not implemented because the implementing authorities are as corrupt as anybody else. So this is the reason that why people actually, because there is no law, there is no safety, and therefore they put their money outside Pakistan. And then terrorism. Can you believe this thing that this money has been used in a extremist organization to fund against Pakistan, against Pakistan's very vital organizations, very vital organs of the state? This money has been, they coerce, they subjugate. Then what happened? Will the people of Pakistan give the tax? Mr. Hafiz Sheikh, one of the finest economic minister we had, he worked with the World Bank, now he's in Dubai. You know, he said that we have identified 7 lakhs when it is about 8 years ago. Now, 30 lakhs of people have been identified who can easily pay the tax. Has the government of Pakistan moved? Has anybody actually gone to them? Why don't you pay the tax? And why the practice is, why they don't pay the tax, and they know, because they are very friendly to the people actually who frame the law, who regulate the law, who legislate the law, they are very friendly with them. So how then the final aspect, you know, which I'll put, because I have already, I'm already 2 minutes are left. Now, what's the social aspect of the society in Pakistan? You know, I've been writing column, I've been writing books for the last 25 years. I've been giving TV programs for the last 25 years, both print media and electronic media. Believe me, now Ramadan is coming, you know, I have started giving. You see the burqa clad women, children, they are throwing the street of Karachi. There are a lot of people actually who are here. They don't have the job. They say 60% of people in Pakistan is a young, because of young people. They are non-technical, they are half-technical, they are educated. Do they get the job? Mr. Nawaz Sharif, the Prime Minister of Pakistan, at a precarious situation, he has left Pakistan, he is in London. Now, he has gone 60 times abroad from Pakistan. How much FDI he brought back to Pakistan? Did he bring any wealth to Pakistan? Did he bring any technology to Pakistan? Did he spark any growth in Pakistan? These are the relevant questions. I can go on speaking and speaking, but I don't want actually, because my mind is hurt. I know that these are not our people. It's a very small 8 lakh aadmi who are ruling Pakistan with strong muscles. Can you stand against them? We have been fighting for the press freedom. We went to the jail. Then what happened? Again, now see the media. Media is, you know, they're right. This is such a powerful media today, free media. But can they change the society? Can they change the politician? Can they change any establishment which is operating in Pakistan? No, they cannot change. Every day there is after 8 o'clock, there is a talk show, rights criticizing, fighting, nothing will come. So what I said, that sometimes, I tell you honestly, technically it may be right because you are transferring your money for a safe haven, but morally it's not right. You are snatching the rights of the people of Pakistan. You are snatching the rights of the poor people whom you should really empower. You should give them money, the job, the digitalization, and you put money into the agriculture sector, which is the largest employment sector of Pakistan. You never do it. You know, so what's happening? There is a vast difference between heaven and heart now. And I tell you before I close, this country is going to face a civil war. If not today, sometime next, because laws, bookish knowledge about taxation law, about the different aspects of the law, it will not yield any result until unless the people in Pakistan, they are economically, socially empowered. Thank you very much.